What's up, everybody? I'm Nat.
I'm Sean, and we're in a group called 303.
And right now you're watching rollingstone.com. Let's see, our essential album that we listened to while we were making Streets of Gold.
To Marina and the Diamonds.
Yeah, it was Marina and the Diamonds.
And Ellie Goulding. It was kind of like...
Yeah, it was kind of a girl pop medley while we were making some...
Yeah, that didn't...
Brat rock or whatever people call it. I've always been attracted to women singers. And like, I don't know, to me the female voice just like cuts really well over electronic music. And so I've always been like a Bjork fan.
And I think like Marina and the Diamonds, like her lyrics are just so good. And she has such a cool style, so...
I think what Streets of Gold, like the song and kind of the whole feel of the album, I think it's just it's an expansion on the last stuff we did. And I think we, like, you know, like I said, we were trying to broaden like both the musical tapestry that we were working with and also the lyric stuff. And I think, you know, we wanted to definitely continue and keep the same vein that we started with, making fun pop songs that are a little different, you know, and like hopefully a little bit more edgy than other pop songs, and like experimenting with different sounds and mixing up genres and stuff, and then just take that further. The key in the studio gadget, we had this little Mattel toy that...
Loops, yeah, they gave us like the prototype to play it, because it's like a beat. It's like Simon Says, but for the 21st century, I guess. And it's like you put your hands through it and it reads the sensors and stuff. Key person to have in the studio was the engineer, Steve. Steve is like the all-around... he's a great engineer, like he went to school, but he was a magician. Like he was the assistant under the coach that taught
David Copperfield,
yeah. So he would just come and just do magic, like all of a sudden like Steve, can you fix like you know, this cable or something? And he's just like, sure, and then he'll like cough up a card and be like, was this your card?
Working with Kesha was actually a funny story, because we wrote that song, we wrote My First Kiss like a year and a half ago, and Sean had written the like My First Kiss went a little like this part, and we were like, oh, it'd be cool if a girl came in and sang that part as a call response. And the producer we were working with was like, oh, I'm working with this girl, she's like kind of crazy, like whatever, but she's really cool and she should come and do it. And we're like, all right, yeah, whatever.
Yeah, so we worked with her on that, and actually became like, through all that, we became actually really good friends, and she's an awesome girl. And we kept in touch, and you know, then after that, a little after that, she came to New York to work on her album, and called to ask if we would help her with blah blah blah, and that's how that happened.
I think one of the essential new people that we'd never worked with before we worked on this album was Greg Kirsten. We did a few songs with him, and actually I got into Greg's work because of the Lily Allen work that he did and the Bird and the Bee, which is kind of fits in my girl pop fetish. He is the nicest dude, who is like the most talented guy as well, and his business ethics and music, it's the best possible way, and I feel like it set a really good example and set a good precedent for when we kind of started working on the record.